When we finally got down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that.
Digital painting has been constantly progressing since the 80s. To be able to paint with inks, acrylics, oils, watercolors, with unlimited canvases, every hue and shade in the visual spectrum, and the freedom to adjust and even remove layers without scrapping the whole design, is just a few of the advantages over the physical counterpart. This modern form of art is used in game artwork and movies as well as being a hobby. The industry is growing quick, and the progression of hardware is granting more authentic inputs and ease of use. Microsoft have taken aim at the professional graphic design market and have produced a pretty amazing specialized product. This is the Surface Studio. A long way since the Dubner Paint System in 1988. The Surface Studio is an all-in-one PC digital workstation in an impressive form factor. It's not cheap by any means. The majority of the price is going into the display, which is something you really need to see in person. It's a 28-inch PixelSense touch display with a massive resolution of 4500 by 3000. It's glossy and slightly reflective, but it produces an amazing color gamut. Each screen is individually calibrated to a host of profiles that can be easily changed with a quick swipe from the right. All this is sitting inside a brushed aluminium housing that's only 13mm thin, connected to what Microsoft are calling the zero gravity hinge. The design of this hinge is a little different to what I was first expecting. The screen and the arms don't move independently. Rather, as you lower the hinge, the screen will tilt more horizontal. And when you pull it back up, it returns to a more vertical view. This is actually a great design. Pushing on the screen, leaning on it, riding on it, doesn't move it at all. You've got to make that right magic push up or down, and it will move effortlessly. And it feels really slick. As well as being beyond 4K, we also get that 3:2 aspect ratio, giving you a lot more height in your workspace, which digital artists will appreciate. Sitting below the screen is the base that powers the whole unit. There's a couple of configurations. The one we have here includes a Skylake Core i7, 32GB of RAM, and a GTX 980M. Now, that GPU is becoming outdated quickly, especially because it's the mobile version. But when you consider the use case, the hardware does make sense. That's a decent processor paired with a large quantity of RAM, ideal for graphics programs such as Photoshop, which are less GPU heavy yet still has a dedicated card to make use of some of the hardware accelerated features found inside these programs. The only real disappointing factor is the hard drive. While there is 128 gigs on an M.2, the remaining 2TB is sitting on a standard HDD. Something else rather lackluster was the I/O. On the side of the screen you have volume and the power button, and that's it. The rest of the ports are found on the back of the base, and it has 4 standard USB 3s, Ethernet, mini display, a full-size SD card slot, and a headphone jack. You won't be finding any USB-C or Thunderbolt 3. Of course, this would have been more accessible placing these ports on the front, so this is a case of aesthetics over functionality. Having to reach around the back to plug anything in does get tiresome, but luckily, you probably won't have to be plugging many things in, at least as far as peripherals go, thanks to everything being powered by Bluetooth. In the box, Microsoft includes their new mouse, keyboard, and of course the Surface Pen. The mouse is light, almost a bit too light to the point where it feels a little cheap. The scroll wheel is also very narrow, but it does have an extra satisfying click to it. The keyboard on the other hand is great. Besides looking nearly exactly like the Apple keyboard, the base is that same brushed aluminium. The keys have nice travel and a good bounce to each key, and I found it enjoyable to type on. The Surface Pen included in the box is the same one that came with the Surface Pro 4, and can also magnetically attach to the side of the display. It's fluid to draw with, and I had no problems when it came to any sort of latency. This jumps up a gear when you pair it with Microsoft's other new Bluetooth peripheral, the Surface Dial. This is a small metal dial with the base of the unit being made from rubber. Once you pair this to your machine, you can either place this on the desk next to you or sit it right on the screen itself, and it grants access to features from inside the program you're using. So for example, you can turn the dial to increase your brush size or cycle through colors. As you turn the dial, you get small clicks of haptic feedback, and the whole thing feels very smooth. At the moment, app support is a little restricted, but for most programs like Photoshop and Windows Sketchpad, I found it really quite handy to use. And if you were to take the time to get used to accessing your tools through this dial, it could be a pretty efficient way to work. You can even use it on your desktop to control the screen brightness or volume, so I think it's a pretty cool addition to any workstation. What it really comes down to is Microsoft have produced a sleek and professional digital workstation. The build quality is stunning, the screen is sharp, and that hinge gives you the freedom to work in the orientation that suits you. Everything cohesively works together. The quality of this product is at the top of the spectrum. and so is the price. The majority of that money is going into one of the best displays I have ever seen. The only worry I have is in a few years' time when the hardware starts to date. There's no way to upgrade the components inside the base, and it's not like you can remove that screen and use it on your new rig. As it stands, this is a serious contender in the professional digital art scene, and if you were to own one, I could guarantee you would love it. You can check it out yourself on display in a few of our stores, or online at pbtech.co.nz. I'm Eli from PBTech. Remember to like, subscribe, and I'll catch you next time.